Hi, this is Frank from Walking for Health and Fitness with show number 14. Now, my goal is to do 52 consecutive weeks, 14 down and 38 to go. In today's weekly walking, tips and inspiration. Now, since it's the beginning of March, it's a 31-day March, I'm going to call this the Foot Care Habits for Walkers show because you have a long march. Get it? So today's show 14 topics are inspirational quotes. Number one, it's from famous DJ Casey Kasem and his catchphrase. We have walking tip number one, and that's 10 tips to keep your feet healthy for walking. In the show notes, I'll have a checklist for you to download. We have eating right, recipes by Stacey. Today's background image, interesting, and I forgot to talk about it last week, but it ties in so well with the review of the last show I did. So stay tuned for that. Walking tip number two, and that's the importance of wearing a good quality sock when you're walking, and at any time, but especially when you're walking. I have a free offer for you, 7-day trial from Blinkist. Nutritional news, okay, for coffee drinkers. I'm a huge coffee drinker. Coffee and the belly fat connection. And then we end it off, we finish it with inspirational quote number two, which is an Irish proverb. Okay, so my mother-in-law would be happy with that. So on with the show. An inspirational quote number one, keep your feet on the ground and keep reaching for the stars. And that is by celebrity DJ Casey Kasem. He has since passed away. But keep your feet on the ground and really keep reaching for the stars. Now, do you display an inspirational quote around your home, your office, wherever you work out, anything? Share it. Send it to me. Or it's in my Facebook group, Your First Walking Group. Look up Frank Ring and you'll find that. Or email me, frank@walkingforhealthandfitness.com. Also, all of the inspirational quotes that I show are in the show notes, so you can print that out as is and display it someplace for yourself. And walking tip number one, 10 tips to keep your feet healthy for walking. Now, over the course of your lifetime, your feet will experience more wear and tear than any other body part. They're more prone to injury, and they're the most common physical ailment that we have. Having healthy feet allow you to move along with balance and with speed. Now, some basic foot care. Foot care is of vital importance. Just think, if you neglect a minor problem or have an injury to the foot, the recovery time is increased dramatically because you really can't afford to keep off your feet. You injure your shoulder, your arm, you can keep it immobile and still pretty much live your life. But your feet, you need to be mobile and you need to get around. So take care of your feet and they will give you years of pain-free service. Now, the following is the Walking for a Health and Fitness Foot Care Checklist. And as I said, you can download the show notes and have this all in a nice PDF here. So wash your feet daily. That's number one. Number two, completely dry your feet after bathing. Damp feet provide a breeding ground for bacteria and odor. Number three, to help prevent dry, cracked feet, massage in a good thick lotion into your feet before you dress and again before you go to bed. Number four, add a little foot powder to your shoes each day to help absorb perspiration. Number five, wear fresh socks or hosiery daily. Tip number six, cut your toenails straight across to help avoid ingrown toenails. Now afterwards, smooth down the nail edges with an emery board or a nail file. Tip number seven, inspect your feet daily for blisters, for corns, for calluses, swelling, or any other problems, and treat them accordingly. This is especially true if you suffer from diabetes. Number eight, give your shoes a rest. Now, alternating pairs of shoes allows them to completely dry out and gives the padding time to return to normal shape. This makes shoes last longer and keeps your feet healthier. Number nine, give yourself a weekly feet treat. Foot treat, feet treat. Massage your feet with warm oil mixed with a few drops of essential oil such as lavender, eucalyptus, or peppermint to de-stress and relax your feet. Peppermint especially just feels awesome on your feet, so try that out. And number 10, if you're overweight, lose some pounds. Excess weight adds enormous pressure to your already stressed feet. And a bonus tip. Now, perform your own homemade physical therapy. Take a tennis ball or any other object that you could roll under your feet. Golf ball is good, but it's a little hard. The tennis ball is a little bit softer, you know, and rub it back and forth under the balls of your feet. You're sitting at your desk, your home office, doing this little massage feels great. So place that tennis ball on the ground and gently roll your foot under it. Roll it under your foot for a few minutes. It'll help loosen up the plantar fasciitis, which is runs along the bottom of the foot. And the plantar, much less likely to become irritated. And that's a huge problem. And it's awful. I suffered from that with one foot years ago. And then by favoring one foot, I've strained the other foot, the other plantar. So having both of them was awful for a few days. So put enough pressure on the ball to give yourself a nice deep massage. You may feel a little soreness. That's good. But back off if you feel any pain. Very important. We never want to feel pain. Create your own self-care routine between the oils, between the tennis ball, and you'll be walking on them for years to come. The background image segment. So I got a number of great responses from show number 13, and that was my self-care theme. Okay, if you haven't missed it, the link is up here. Check it out. I go really into depth about self-care. If you missed it, here's what I covered. Okay, walking tip number one in that was self-care for walkers. That's connecting with yourself. The walking tip number two of self-care for walkers was connecting to the world around you. Then I had some bonus tips. So it was a long show. Creating joy and satisfaction in your life. And bonus tip number two was a walking meditation. Okay, so I got so engrossed in that show and so excited talking about it that I skipped over the section where I talked about the background image, which I usually do. So this image is my meditation spot. Basically, this image is me taking a picture of what I see. I'm up above, I'm sitting on a rock, it's a quiet place. So it's about 2.5 miles from my house. It's off of a service road. It's about another 100 yards, 70 to 100 yards into the woods onto this rock, which is set down a little bit, but still above. So I'm covered and it's just a place that's quiet, a lot of solitude. There's no hiking trails nearby. It's just my place to meditate, to pray, to think, reflect, everything I need to do for my solitude and my self-care. So that's today's background image that I forgot to share last week. Now, do you have a favorite spot you like to escape to? Please send me an email. Give me the image. I'll post it on the show. Tell me as much or as little about it as you'd like. It's frank@walkingforhealthandfitness.com. So if you like what you see and hear on the show, please consider subscribing. The more subscribers, the better the algorithm for YouTube kind of gets it out there to other walkers. So, I'd like to share this with as many people as possible. Ring the bell, share it, do whatever you have to do, but I appreciate it. Thank you. And I'm going to call this the Blinkist Spotlight. So in the last few shows, I've talked about an app called Blinkist. Now, I do make a commission from it if you purchase Blinkist. The disclaimer is in the show notes. And this week's Spotlight, though, is on a book by T. Harv Eckert. It's called The Secret of the Millionaire Mind, Mastering the Inner Game of Wealth. So I listen to audiobooks when I walk, and many of the long books, are hours long. I've begun using an app called Blinkist, and it's a great concept. They've taken the idea of many of the best-selling and current nonfiction books and reduced them to what they call blinks. Books like Secrets of a Millionaire Mind are among the many best-selling books of all time that they've condensed in this format. Each blink is between 15 and 20 minutes long. There is also a transcription of it. You could also sit at home and read what they've condensed it down to, okay? So I'll listen to a blink on my walk, 15 to 20 minutes. Then I'll spend time reflecting on what I just heard. I'll take notes in my notes app if anything really strikes me. If I go on a long walk, I listen to another blink. That's just another piece of knowledge information that it's, you know, stored for me. Makes the time go by fast. It makes me think a little bit deeper. So Harv Eker's book will have you questioning your relationship with money and wealth and how people with money think differently than people who don't have money. So it's opened my eyes up to a lot of things in my life financially. And I listened to the complete book years ago. And this was a nice refresher on what I listened to right 3 or 4 years ago. Was the first time I had listened to Harv's book. So this was really great. So right now, for viewers of this show, Blinkist has a 20% off offer if you buy a subscription, or you get a 7-day free trial, and you get a 7-day free trial if you use the link below. So again, Blinkist, it's a great tool to have at your disposal when you're walking 15 to 20 minutes long. Some really great content is on Blinkist. They have so many topics. And in this Eating Right Recipes by Stacey, that's pancakes underscore Stacey on Instagram. And she sent me this recipe, roasted Brussels and radishes with pancetta, fried sage, and balsamic vinaigrette. Stacey says it's to serve great as a side dish, a great side dish. So the recipe is in the show notes. It looks great. Check it out. And walking tip number 2, and that's the importance of wearing good socks while you're walking. Okay, socks, those white stretchy things you put on your feet when you go to work out. Any pair will do the job, right? Well, is more involved with a good sock than a simple yes. We wear socks to keep our feet dry and prevent blisters or sores from developing. Going sockless can result in conditions such as athlete's foot. Wearing socks also prevent odor, which develops due to many sweat glands that are in your foot, when purchasing socks, look for these features. A good pair of socks will absorb sweat, prevent friction between your feet and the inside of the shoe to reduce blisters. Low friction allows you to easily slide in and out of your shoe or boot. A good weave in the design helps to promote blood flow to keep your feet feeling rested and fresh. Good socks have a wicking ability that moves sweat away from your feet and help the sweat evaporate quickly. Good socks retain their elasticity wash after wash. Now, I've tested out several pairs of socks since I've been a walker. Synthetic materials like polyester, acrylic, and nylon are your best bet as they help wick that moisture away to prevent the blisters. Now, make sure that you get a sock that doesn't bunch around the toes or gather in the heels, which can cause blisters and hot spots. When buying socks, that phrase, you get what you pay for, is so true. Open any new pair of socks, they look great. But the real measure of how good a sock is after a few washings. Low-cost socks generally stretch out quickly, and they lose many of the features that they promote. My favorite socks are made by a company called Caramote. Caramote socks have been my go-to when I do my weekend long walks. They're comfortable, durable, and the added compression keep my feet from feeling tired and achy. I like the breathability of it. That's that moisture wicking feature that keep my feet dry. Their easy glider technology makes it easy to slip into my walking shoes, which isn't a big deal, but more importantly, my higher hiking boot. Slip right in. It's great. These are by far the best socks I have ever worn. And since I've been walking exclusively, you spend so much time on your feet throughout the day. So treat them right and invest in the best quality sock. In the show notes is a link to Caramote socks, and they've provided me with a discount to offer to you for using that code. Again, I make a small commission from it, but these are excellent, excellent socks. And some nutritional news this week. The coffee belly fat connection. Good news for the Java drinkers out there, myself included. Your morning cup could give you an unexpected health boost. A recent study in the Journal of Nutrition found that for women, drinking coffee every day, whether or not the brew was caffeinated, was associated with having lower levels of belly fat. Researchers suspect that this is because coffee beans contain bioactive compounds that help regulate weight. Extra fat carried in the abdominal region is especially harmful because it wraps around organs deep inside the body and contributes to the development of serious chronic problems such as heart disease. So, if you're already a coffee fan, sip away. If you're not, think about picking up the coffee habit. It's addicting and it's great. Inspirational quote number 2, an old Irish proverb that says, "Your feet will bring you to where your heart is." Okay, again, an old Irish proverb. My Irish mother-in-law is proud of me. So if you have a walking health, fitness, nutritional answer or question you'd like an answer to, contact me, frank@walkingforhealthandfitness.com. Check out my website, walkingforhealthandfitness.com. There it is. So your next step, very simple, download the show notes for the full checklist of the 10 tips to keep your feet healthy for walking. As always, all of the images in the show are in that show notes. You can print those out, display them anywhere. So this is Frank for Walking for Health and Fitness. Thank you for watching my show. Walk on.